Legion has really had, like, a ways, and we got some more. War, Planet of the Apes. I think, if I'm correct, this is the last one they're doing. This actually leads up to... no, you know what would be actually really cool? Because the other one takes place so far in the future. This is like, do this like Star Wars. We got the ending first. Star Wars, we had the middle. I understand. We started with the end for the most part. Or maybe that could be, I don't know what that technical term would be for something, not the final act, but something before that. We did the ending. This could be the beginning. I'm hoping that the movies weren't like the beginning-ish and the middle. It'd be really cool if the war and all these other things from this movie on back, this new trilogy, that this is, what do you call it? This is how it all started. And then hopefully that'd be kind of cool if we did get a middle where humanity has actually officially lost and we get to see the world shaped to what it is. I don't actually think we'll get to that. I think for the most part, they are depicting humanity at a loss here, which I guess maybe it's the last Planet of the Apes movie, and then maybe we get to see it. It'd be really cool if they tacked onto the series and say, hey, the apes won the war, but the humans have returned. And it's after the original movies, you know, where the guy goes in the future or whatever that was, and the Statue of Liberty's there, another continuation after those original movies where humans make a resurgence, and then we murder the monkeys. Chimps, everything else in between. Either way, that would be really cool. I have not actually looked up to see what they're doing. Maybe they'll have something like that in the works that I just don't know about. Maybe this is the end of all of it. I don't know. But let's just get into it. Check it out. See what it's all about. Let's hope it's good. Woody Allen, man. Whoo. Or wait, Woody Harrelson? Did I say the wrong name? Woody Allen. Really? What up, Caesar? Oh shit. It's him, isn't it? Oh no.
I see, girl. I think you human. Oh, but you ape like me.
No, no. A second generation, huh?
How long have you been here?
Long. Long time.
What the hell is going on?
Home. Are there more like you? More apes from zoo.
Dead. All dead. Long time. Human gets sick. Ape gets smart.
The mocap man.
Kill ape. But not me. I run.
You learn to speak.
Listen. Human. Bad ape. Bad ape. No. No touch. That's mine.
What is he? Then none of the other ones can speak.
Friends, special day.
How can he talk? It's so bizarre.
You keep. She keep.
Where did you get this?
Bad place.
Oh shit.
Human zoo. Bad human.
Bad humans. Soldiers.
Uh-oh.
Soldiers.
There it is.
Can you take us?
Human zoo? No. No. No, go back there. Very safe here. Never go back. Look. More snow. Cannot go. Must stay.
Who's that voice actor, man? I actually gotta look that up. I gotta look that up right now. I wonder if it'll tell me. I wonder if it'll tell me right now. That was good. The mocap. I think it's mocap. I don't know if this movie's actually mocap or not. It looks like it. Motion capture. You know, when you put the little dots on your face, just for anybody that didn't know. I kind of want to know now. Who was that actor? Because, damn, I liked it. I was always that person that's like, no, like, Human Extinction. What was that, Morgan? Or the new, what's this movie? Well, shit, I forgot what it was. When does this come out, actually? Oh, July 24th. Oh, I didn't know that fucking Andy Serkis is the fucking... Of course he is. Son of a bitch. And it is Woody Harrelson, by the way. Steve Zahn is in this. He might have been the voice actor. I actually do not know. Let's see if we can find an IMBD that kind of explains. Don't play this video, thank you. I actually want to know. They didn't give us a name on who that was. It's Koba, I believe, is the bad one, right? Oh, Bad Ape. Oh, it is Steve Zahn, the guy from. He was in such movies as Joyride, Dallas Buyers Club. What was that? The crazy movie he was in where he killed people. The Perfect Getaway with Mila Jovovich. Yeah, that's him, all right. Let's see if I can... no, I can't. Steve Zahn. Z-A-H-N. Steve. Yeah. So, yeah, okay. He sounded kind of familiar. Maybe that's... But maybe not too familiar where I had to look it up. That's really cool, man. It's looking really good. But, like, there's a game coming out where it's called, like... not Detroit, but it's like, or something Detroit, where it's like the androids want to become like alive. And I was like, man, it's crazy. Like, you could definitely make like the right wing neo-Nazi or the KKK, like the discrimination for apes or cyborgs or fucking the people like Morgan, which were artificial humans. Or that one, Ex Machina, where it was the girl that looked like that was a robot, but it's kind of like, there's one thing to say about accepting all human beings, white, black, whatever. I'm cool with that. I have no problems. But is there really an ice cream? I mean, it is 120 degrees in Arizona, roughly. So I understand why there's an ice cream truck outside, but Jesus, come on. So yeah, the racist stuff like that in real life here. Of course, we're like, those people, just come on. Why do you got to be that way? KKK. But if, like, monkeys rose up or androids, something like that, let me know. Let me know in the comments down below. Would you be like, oh, no, life for everybody? Like, or would you be like, you know, death to anything that's not human? Death to all the apes or the chimps or the monkeys or whatever it is that, you know, Caesar and everything else that he has underneath his umbrella. Robots. It doesn't matter how AI you are. It doesn't matter how sentient you are. As a human, would I ever try to kill God? I'm thinking no. So my version or my views would be an android or something AI like that shouldn't aspire to go superior than man, since man was its creator, right? That's kind of the thing. Morgan was a great kind of thing where artificial humans, but they were stronger and better. And that's the flaw that humans make. Humans are making things beyond them. So if you are replacing yourself or us. They were trying to make, you know, apes and chimps and everything already really smart. That's a loud car. Apes and whatever, really smart. Why would you give them why would you take their capacity for intelligence and take what we have that made us superior and gift it to them, and then give them the ability to kind of think beyond a primal situation? They have the strength, and now they have the reasoning and capability to process real thought on a global scale, not like an environmental scale. Why would you try to replace your own species that way? Progression? That's delusion. That's not progress. Mad scientist, some people always joke that a mad scientist is just really somebody that's just trying to go further beyond any bounds. And nope, it's called stupidity. Until you are smart enough to take whatever you've created and have it in an isolated area that can never affect the world at large, you are wrong. That's why when we make, you know, diseases that could destroy the planet 10 times over, they're locked underground like 10 miles with like 3 million doors, airtight, bulletproof, nuke-proof to the surface. Why are you just going to have some random asshole at some college lab and allow him to create an animal that could just get out and breed? That, unless they sterilized it. It's been a long time. It's been like 10 years plus that since the movie's been out. Still, whether it's an ape, a primate, a robot, an android, or an artificial human, I gotta say for me, the line is drawn at humanity, and everything else that comes after that should know its place. And then maybe we, you know, after the lines are drawn, then there's zones and integration to society, if that's what society deems okay. But in all these scenarios, it goes from zero to holy fuck in 0.1 gigawatt of a second. And we're already in a doomsday scenario. So, like, you know, Morgan, different story. Morgan's also kind of the scary psychological thriller movie that had the girl from Transcendence and the girl from Iron Man 2. It's a really hot girl. I forgot her name. Something. Either way. yeah, so it's all those things, man. Would you be like that? Oh, yeah, just let all the androids just run free and they're the superior ones, or apes, or artificial humans. Or would you be like, no, man, we got to draw a line. We either got to stop them or stop the people making them. Hell, human cybernetic integration? Who knows? Let me know. There's a conversation for all. It's not just about Planet of the Apes. It branches off into all kinds of stuff everywhere. Because it's a doomsday scenario where humans lose. That's what this story is. Where humanity does not make it out. And it really reminds me of kind of like X-Men for anybody. I don't know if the War of Apes, Planet of the Apes, was written before X-Men or Marvel came to be. I don't exactly know. Either or, if you don't know what planet is, War or Apes. It's kind of like X-Men with mutants. Humans didn't want to be replaced by the mutants and Marvel or the X-Men series. And it was like this, you know, no-win situation for everybody. How would you do? You know, at least with a mutant, you're the same species. Just one has abilities, one doesn't. Do I get mad if a football player can jump higher than me? Nope. It's just how he was, you know, born. Same thing with mutants. They're just people with different abilities. They're still people. But this scenario, again, apes, synth people, android, it's all things that were created by man and then replaced man. And that's a crazy doomsday scenario. I'm going to get out of here. I've rambled enough. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. If you like the content, you can always like, subscribe, and share. Remember, it's completely up to you. I do appreciate it, though. We're almost at 3,000 subs and made it. I don't know yet. And yeah, thanks for watching again. Thanks for hanging out. Once again, my name is Azra. I'll see you on whatever video I'm doing next. I'd love to hear all the comments. If you guys want to leave any comments down below, discussing any doomsday scenario involving the lines of man sabotaging man and then we extinct ourselves, and or Terminator being one of them with Skynet, where, you know, man made a machine, and in the future, machine went back in time to kind of try to get its evolution quicker and then stop the rebellion. It's all doomsday stuff, and it's always really interesting to think about. Again, later, guys.